I was told I was here to only see Mauricio. I
didn't.
this is awesome seeing you. I'm just really happy to be up here. I'm gonna tell you a story. We met each other, we were like both 16, 17, 15, 16, and it was really interesting. I met him, he was from Canada, he was explaining to me that he was English, he explained to me, I didn't understand Canada, Jamaica. I didn't know that stuff. but listen, I heard that he had won the World Junior Championship. And I was supposed to go fight in the World Junior Championship in Dominican Republic, one of those Caribbean countries. I didn't go, and he won. And we found out who won. Because of the paranoia, we can't go to the Dominican Republic. They have revolutions over there. All right, but anyway, that's what he thought. He had that mindset. So we sparred, and when we were kids, we became very good friends. And I was young, but I had two girls. Remember, I had those girls from Montreal and stuff. Explaining to them, and I said, listen, hey, listen, they were Jamaican, you know, and they were Montreal, but they're French Jamaican. And I said, hey, I have a Jamaican up here right now. And then I said, hey, look, they're Jamaican. He said, oh, well, let me talk to him. And he went and he was talking to him and stuff. And we were young, you know, Lennox is real tall. He's 6'5", and he's probably 16. And remember when you were dancing, like, how are you dancing? It was like that, but it was something like the thing. Yeah. I do too now. But listen, but really why it was close, it meant a lot to me because Cuss was alive then, right? And what was your guy named Monty? Arnie was alive then, right? And Arnie, like Cuss, had put all of his hopes and dreams into Lennox. And no one knew us. You know, we were just two guys coming up. And then the 84 Olympic. And then he fought Tyrell Biggs, and he was young, but he was just a young guy, but he made it to the Olympics. And it was still a good fight, but he was a little apprehensive because the Olympics was overwhelming. You know, we were both little young kids. I was 17, he was 18. But he overcame all that, and then he won the next Olympics. But when he lost in 84 in Los Angeles, do you remember when he lost, we were just walking around like two schmucks? Shit. we just walking around. God. But I want to make this short, but we overcame all our adversities, and that was just I don't even know how to explain it. What do we call it? A learning ground, learning experience. How we handle our losses, and we learn not to get discouraged if we get beat or we get humiliated. We know this is our goal, to be champion of the world, and we were only in our mind. We were champions before we became champions because we had a lifestyle. We lived a lifestyle, and we were just kids. 15 and 16, 16 and 17, and then Cuss said, "Your two are gonna fight for the championship one day." Mm-hmm. He said, "You are fighting one day for the title." And we're just kids, but we both knew we were gonna be champions, because that's what our goal, that's all we ever talked about. Even when we were at the house, "Hey man, what about this guy?" He said, "What about that guy?" He said, "Yeah, I'm gonna fight that guy, that guy's tough." I said, "Hey, what about Willie DeWitt? You ever spar with him or work with him?" I think you did work with him or something back then. And we just really enthusiastic about our life. We were very concerned about our endeavors. And everything turned out good because we're here right now. And we're old, right?
Yeah.
I'm saying, I'm looking at him, and they say he's 50. And it's really ironic because, and this is real talk, no offense to anybody, 50, when we were 18, 84, if you were 50, you were fucked up, man.
You know, we're
right, like, look, at 50, our families didn't look good. That's because we were blessed with good lifestyles, and we still get to gain weight a little bit, but we still don't look like we could look like them. When we were fighting, we were out of shape. We were really Hey, but this is really something that's interesting. Listen, we come from the poorest places that God could create. It was one of the places, one of the hemisphere, Brownsville, Brooklyn, and then it comes from like Trenchtown and all that stuff. And that's really scary stuff. You know, where we come from, sometimes when people come out, they look like monsters because they had acid thrown on them and stuff. And we come from that world, but look what we did and we overcame that. That's just the biggest, that's the biggest accomplishment, that we didn't become victims to our environments.
Yeah. Because,
I don't want to say anything wrong. I'm sure we have really awesome, ugly stories to tell, but we don't tell them no more because we're beautiful now. You know, they only exist when we're miserable. I'm happy to be here. And I don't know why I would have loved to have been here. For some reason, I think if your guys would have told me I would have came here for length, I wouldn't have came. This is an honor for me to be here.
Oh.
You know, this is really an honor for me to be here. Plus, you guys know me. If you know my story, I've never been to school before. I never been to school. But, you know, I've been to school, but I didn't learn. I robbed the teachers. I robbed the teachers. All right? We need Dorothy. We can't get, we robbed the teachers. Snap, they robbed the teachers. There's all types of stuff. But anyway. You know, for a guy like me, that's, you know, I mean, I come from really bad, but I'm like a really bad place. You know, if somebody told me their father was their daughter's, father, I wouldn't be surprised. So really, y'all, that's pretty interesting. You know?
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak.
Right, but that's just the world we live in, and if I never had the opportunity to engage in combat with him and these guys, I would never have my kids go to these Ivy League schools. My kids can never make fun of me. My kids think they're smarter than me, but they are, but they're not. They can read better and they can put sentences better and they know more about physics and all that stuff. But that's all because I had somebody like him. I had someone to fight. We can make fights. We can break records. And when we're fighting, listen, guys from the inner city during the 80s, they never came up. We were the first guys that, like, an inner city kid. Guys that made money by shooting people or telling people the guys in there that you want to kill or something. And being that, and this, we became a world-known figure. We were statistics that became specialists. And that's why we're here, really. And I mean, it's really, this is just a pleasure. Now, if anybody don't know, I love fighters. You know, I'm just a fighter. If I was a woman, I would fuck fighters. No. I'm telling you the truth, though. The truth. I love fighters. I love them. I love them because I'm. When you think about it, right? When you really think about it, I was going nowhere in my life until I saw a little fucking Roberto Duran fight.
Oh.
And I said, this is what I want to dedicate my life to. You know, can you believe this guy's a little hell rating? He's irritable, he's nasty, he's an irritant and stuff. And why would I want to emulate him? Because I felt like I was nothing. And he made nothing look beautiful. I said, wow, I like him. But he told guys, fuck you, and I'm going to kill you next time. I'm going to kill you. I'm going to suck my fucking dick. I said, I can say that on television. Brother, please. Yeah. you don't feel like you did when we were younger. So we just get stuff. Before we when we hugged each other, nothing could go in, but now stuff could go in. When we were younger, you were getting walled. Boom, baby. The Hulk and the Rocket. Boom.
Boxing, there are a number of sanctioning organizations, but there's none more prestigious than the World Boxing Council. Mike mentioned Mauricio, who's a good friend of so many in this room. Mauricio's dad, who's a legend in the sport, ran the WBC for years and years and years, and I think the greatest tribute I can make to my friend Mauricio Suleiman is not only has he followed in the footsteps of his father, but I think his father's probably so very proud of him that he actually learned from his mistakes. And I think that you can't have a better president of the WBC than Mauricio Suleiman. And I'd like to bring up Mauricio to make a presentation for Mike Tyson.
Buenas noches. Me da mucho gusto. No, I'm going to speak Spanish. I prepared something that I was going to say. It's going to be very hard after Lou, after Josh, after the comedian. Maybe if I don't say bad words, nobody will even acknowledge what I'm saying. Rosie Perez, she's the queen of boxing. I'm just extremely proud to be here tonight. We have people from all over the world. We have Sasha Povetkin and Mr. Ravinsky from Russia. Yeah. From Italy, Alberto León, Panama. It's just a thrill to be here with a very important, solid group of persons to celebrate Lennox Lewis and to celebrate Mike Tyson. Most importantly, to celebrate Violet and Kiki. This woman who sacrifice their lives, who suffer so much, every single day, every single night. I said I was gonna make somebody laugh, so I did. When
she got it in, all my other lives got
damaged. Oh my God.
Anyway, when I grew up, I was going to high school in Massachusetts. My father calls me up. It was a Thanksgiving vacation, and he says, "Please fly to Las Vegas. I like to see you. I miss you very much." So I flew to Las Vegas, and my first time ever in Las Vegas, I was 18, no, 15. I could drink. I was drinking. I didn't have fake ID, but I was playing and drinking. That night, the youngest ever to win the heavyweight championship of the world was Mike Tyson.
Yeah!
I was fortunate to be there. Many things happened. Many years went by. Then Lennox Lewis was a champion. And my destiny brought my father to be sick. And we were in the hospital, and he had a beautiful visit from Mike. Mike went to see my father in the hospital. Thank God my father got better for 2 months. So one day we were talking, and he said, "You know, I have one of the things I really want to do. I want to have the best boxers of each division showed in the belt. In the belt is Muhammad Ali and Joe Louis, and then he wanted the current champions, and he wanted the two best of each division." So I wrote a pad, and he said, "Please write down. I'm only gonna say one division, and I don't have to think anything. And I want those belts, the WBC green belt, to always have Mike Tyson and Lennox Lewis in the panels." So, Mike, I would like to present to you the first ever WBC belt with the sixth generation, with your face on the WBC. Thank you very much.
Bravo.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.